Hi friends, today I am going to show you how you can connect a portable generator safely without bike feeding to the utility company's power. As you can see, this is my Champion 7000 running watts inverter generator, which has got a clean energy, just like the power that I get from the utility company. I installed a few cement blocks for the generator to sit. I have installed a ground bar which is 8 feet long. It is a half inch, 8 feet long copper ground rod. I connect this ground to the generator frame. This is my generator power input. It is from GE. I can close it, and it is rain tight. From here, I am running the power on a 10-3 UFB underground cable in a seal tight conduit from Southwire. The cable also is from Southwire. This is a sample of the conduit, the 1-inch conduit. And this is the 10 feet cable that I am going to connect from generator to the power input. This is a sample of the 10-3 underground wire that I have installed. First, I have to connect the 10 feet cable from generator to the power input. Now I have connected the cable from generator to the power input. This is the 250 volt output, twist lock output, it's NEMA L1430. Now I can close it. The generator is supposed to run at least 25 feet from the structure of the house. And this setup is about 30 feet. So I am safely using the generator without getting the carbon monoxide inside the house. From here, the power goes underground. I have buried the cable underground. It goes under the ground, under these bricks. And underground by the side of the house. And from here it goes to the transfer switch. So this is the setup. It is about 75 feet of cable running underground from the generator to the transfer switch. Once the cable is connected to the power input, I can start the generator. It's 245 watts. After the generator has warmed up for about 2 minutes, we can turn the transfer switch from line to generator. The wiring underground comes up by the side of the house and it comes up over here to the transfer switch. This is a Protran transfer switch from Reliance Controls and it is connected to the breaker box. And now it is ready to be connected to the generator. Right now, the generator is connected and I am going to turn the generator power to on position. Right now it is line and I am going to turn it on to the generator. You can see the click. These are the 10 circuits that I am using. When the utility power is back, do not just turn the generator off. First, you need to disconnect the generator power to the house one by one, and then only you should turn the generator off. So after a minute of turning off the generator power to the house, you can safely turn off the generator. Now it is time to turn the generator power off. The main thing to remember: always connect the ground to the generator.